So what we have here is the CH160 ITX case from Deepcool. So ITX case, it's their latest small form factor case. And this is actually quite popular right now. Yung first time na in-stock namin to, naubos lahat agad yun. Tapos nag-stock kami ulit, naubos siya agad lahat ulit. And right now, yung mga in-order namin, hinihintay na lang namin sila magka-stock. And even then, yung mga stock na yun, meron ng owners. So this sells like hotcakes. And that is for a very good reason. So before we go on with the review, just the usual disclaimer. Deepcool sent us this unit for review, but they do not have a say in the final verdict of the video. So, on to the review. So from the get-go, this is very popular right now because it is cheap. So it sells for around 3,000 pesos. I believe the white variant is a little bit more expensive, but in ITX-K standards, that's very, very cheap. So we'll be flashing the specs and the clearances for this case. But the most important spec here is that it can take a really large air cooler as well as a full-size ATX PSU. And couple that with the fact that this is really cheap, plus it's Deepcool, it's very premium, that's the reason why this is very popular right now. Para doon sa mga hindi masyadong aware, yung mga ITX cases, ITX motherboards, you know, mga small form factor components, they're more expensive than their counterpart, you know, normal size ones. And that is usually the greatest barrier to entry to SFF. It's more expensive for basically the same performance. So you're really just paying a premium for smaller dimensions. So number one na pinakamahal doon would be the motherboard, the PSU also. Plus for cooling, you're very usually limited to low profile ones or cases that are designed for AIO. But not anymore with the CH160. So for the glam shots of the build, we did use the white case for this. As well as the Assassin 4S that came along with it. So we probably built the worst case scenario for this. So we used a gigantic air cooler, we used a full-size ATX PSU, plus we used a moderately sized GPU. And after a couple of finessing and tinkering, we did get it to fit, and we'll be flashing the complete build right now. And it looks quite good. But before we get into the build and the build process, let's look at the case first. So this has tempered glass, it doesn't come with a mesh side panel here. Everything here is mesh and it features the, you know, the pixel design of Deepcool. There is a filter on the top, the front, and the bottom mesh panels. And as if to prove a point, yeah, it does come with a handle. Feels quite premium. It's not one of those plastic ones that are easily destroyed after handling them a few times. And I don't know if you can see, but there's virtually no flex when trying to lift the case up with the handle. I'd imagine there'd be some when it comes with a full build, but the attachment of the handle is very clever. There's a full spine here that supports the entire weight of the case through the handle. So no worries there. So for configurations, as stated before, this can support up to an Assassin 4S. So up to 172 millimeters of air coolers. For GPUs, it can support triple slot with up to 305 millimeters of clearance. Plus a full ATX PSU up to 140 millimeters. So for cooling, as I've said, you can have an air cooler there. Also, there are rails that go up to the ceiling or the top panel where you can mount 120 millimeter fans. But that would basically depend on whether you're using an SFF or an ATX PSU. Because speaking of the PSU, for ATX PSUs, you will be orienting it in such a way that it uses this space here, up to here. So there won't be a lot of room for top fans. Also, for our case, there's a slight issue with the handle when using an ATX PSU with this. More on that later. You can also theoretically mount slim fans at the bottom of the case. Although there are no official mounts or official screw points for the bottom fans. And of course, an exhaust fan at the rear. The left side panel is also vented because if you're going to use an SFF power supply, that's going to be where the intake is. And speaking of the panels, the left, the tempered glass, and the top are all removable, but they are screwed in. We're not toolless. While the rest, the front, the back, and the bottom ones are not removable. But with all of the removable panels out of the way, it should give you enough space to work with the build. Speaking of the build experience, it is quite straightforward until you reach the GPU and the cable management for the front panel headers. So as I've mentioned, for our build, we did use an ATX PSU. And although that didn't introduce any difficulties, we did have to work around some of the issues. So number one issue is that on our configuration, the mounting point for the handle interfered with the power supply cable. Speaking of the power supply cable, it does come with a rather funny looking pigtail. So if you're into SFF builds, you might be already familiar with that. But for first timers, you know, do not be alarmed. You do not have any missing items. So another thing, you can't mount a fan at the front if you're going to be using an ATX PSU because there's simply just not enough room. It did come with a multi-purpose bracket. So that's what you're supposed to use if you're going to mount fans. Or in my case, I did mount a SATA SSD right at the front. But I guess the most difficult issue we've faced was the front panel headers. So the front panel headers, they're attached here. So there's a metal thing here that houses all the front panel. So by the way, it has two USB 3s, one USB-C, an audio jack, and of course the power switch. So that's all well and good. However, depending on the size of your GPU or where the power connectors of that would end up, you might have great difficulty with how you're going to manage the front panel cables basically. Because on our case, they did interfere with each other. So we had to finesse and basically tighten and basically cable manage the hell out of that thing before we could connect everything. And speaking of connecting the front panel headers, that is where this case might stump, you know, first time SFF builders. The issue lies on how the GPU can be inserted. And basically, kailangan mo munang tanggalin yung front panel na thing, itong metal na to. So you insert the GPU, make sure it's in place, and then you screw in the front panel. So for the eagle-eyed viewers out there, that's where the issue is. So for most ITX boards, the front panel headers are right in the area of the PCIe connector where the GPU would sit. So if you're going to mount the GPU first, that's going to completely block it. So our tip for that would be to prepare the front panel connectors right where they would end up, not completely connected just yet. Insert the GPU, like install it completely, and then try to reach the headers and completely connect all the connections. And again, depending on your configuration and your GPU, it might be difficult, it might be easy. And due to the fact that the bottom panel is not removable, you don't have a lot of room, especially when you have the PSU already, the cooler already there. But all in all, that's a usual Monday for any SFF builder. So for the overall build quality of the case, it is quite solid. Some of the materials do bend, they do flex, but not in such a way that they're compromised or that we wouldn't recommend it. So this is a 3,000 peso case. So basically, I wouldn't be expecting, you know, indestructible nuclear proof materials here, but they're very solid. So for thermal performance, it's quite good. Even without any case fans, the 6800 XT we use for this remains at around 70 degrees at 100% load and gaming, while the CPU, although just a mere 5600X, averages at around 70 to 75 at full load. Finally, again, Deepcool delivers an excellent case, and the fact that it sells out every time we stock it, even before this video came out, speaks volumes on how well people receive this case. It's not the greatest ITX case, it's not going to be, you know, the most perfect in terms of thermals and the most solid build. However, in one small package, it eliminates the greatest barrier to entry for ITX builds, and that is the cost barrier. You know, SFF builders and enthusiasts have all been well familiar with the ITX premium and that everything else is very expensive. But with the clever configurations that the CH160 offers, you can have your very own ITX build without literally breaking your life savings. Overall, this is a very recommended product. This might be the easiest ITX case to recommend. And if you're interested on getting your very own case or your very own ITX build, hit us up on Facebook and we'll hook you up. See you on the next video.